Hey guys and gals, this next video starts the second half of our unit over quadratic equations. In the second half, we're going to be learning how to solve quadratic equations without the use of our graphing calculator in the graph mode. We're going to be looking at it from what's called an algebraic standpoint. So there's going to be several methods we're going to look at for solving them. The first method is going to involve a formula. And out of all the formulas you're going to ever learn in algebra, this is probably, if not the most important, definitely one of the top five. This is definitely one you're going to want to commit to memory, and this is called the quadratic formula. Okay, so just a quick review before we jump into that formula. When we're solving quadratic equations, okay, and this is what we did in the last unit, we graphed the equations on our calculator, we got a parabola, and then we found the x-intercepts, or we also called those the zeros of the function. So we're going to be doing the same thing in the second half of this unit. We're still going to be finding the zeros of each of these functions, but we're doing this in a way under the assumption that we don't have a graphing calculator nearby. Okay, what happens if we don't have a graphing calculator? How would we solve these problems? And this is what these algebraic methods are for. So like I said, this first method, this is the quadratic formula. This is a really nice method, even though it doesn't look like it when you first see it, because it works for any quadratic equation. Any equation you can think of that is a quadratic, this formula will allow you to find the zeros of that equation. Okay, so if you look down here in this box, this is what the quadratic equation looks like. Assuming you have an equation in standard form already, standard form is again ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. So assuming your equation is set equal to 0 and in this form, then x is always going to be equal to the following. Negative b plus or minus is what that sign is. The square root of b squared minus 4 times a times c, all divided by 2a. Okay, x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. And we'll be repeating that formula several times over the next several weeks during class, but that's an introduction there to that formula. And even though it looks huge and insanely complicated, it's really not too bad. So I'm going to jump right down to example one right now and show you how this formula works. So on this one, we have 2x squared plus 3x minus 9 equals 0. That is our equation. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and list the a, b, and c values for that, since this one's already in standard form. Okay, your a value is the leading coefficient, so your a value is 2. Your b value is the middle coefficient on the x term, which is 3. And then your c value is just your constant, which in this case is negative 9. Okay, so what I want you doing on each problem on your notes and on your homework is copying this formula down exactly as it's written. That way, your brain helps you to commit that to memory. Okay, the more times you write something down, the more often, the more likely you are to remember it. So you're going to be copying the formula down just like this every single problem to help to commit that to memory. So x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. And now here's how this formula works. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put in the parts of the formula that stay put. Okay. And then everything else that's missing from what I've just written here is what we're plugging in. These are the a, b's, and c parts that we need to plug in from the equation. Okay, so let's start here. The first part of the formula is x equals negative b. So that means the opposite of b. So this negative sign here is from the formula. The b value is 3, so that makes this a negative 3. Plus or minus the square root of, the next part is b squared. So I put my 3 in here as well, 3 squared. Make sure you put it in parentheses. Okay, so 3 squared in parentheses. Then we're subtracting the product 4 times a, my a value is 2, so that goes here, times c, my c value is negative 9, so that goes here, and we're dividing it all by 2 times a again, which a again is 2. Okay, so that's how we plug into the formula, just like that. And now we're going to do order of operations to simplify that formula. So moving down to the next step, I'm going to keep my negative 3 out here in front. That's going to be one of the last things I do. One of the first things I do to simplify, though, is I'm going to simplify what's underneath my radical. I know that 3 squared is 9, so I'm going to go ahead and make that 9. And then the next part is where a lot of people tend to mess up, so I want you to be really careful here. You've got a negative 4 times 2 times negative 9. So you have to think really carefully about what that sign is going to be. I have a negative times a negative here, which is a positive, times a positive, which means this sign is now going to become a plus. Okay, so it's negative 4 times 2 times negative 9, which the result is a positive number. 4 times 2 is 8. 8 times 9 is 72. So this becomes positive 72. So you get 9 plus 72 underneath your radical, underneath your square root sign. And then 2 times 2 on the very bottom, don't forget that part, that becomes 4. So negative 3 plus or minus the square root of 9 plus 72 all over 4. Now I'm going to simplify my square root a little bit more. 9 plus 72 is just 81. So you get negative 3 plus or minus the square root of 81 all divided by 4. We know the square root of 81. The square root of 81 is simply 9. Okay, so now you get negative 3 plus or minus 9 all over 4. And now for the last part, I'm going to finally explain to you what that plus or minus sign means, because I'm sure many of you have been wondering that ever since I've been talking about this sign. This sign here signifies that you're going to get, more often than not, two answers to each of your problems. If you remember, when we're graphing parabolas, most times when you graph the parabolas, they intersect the x-axis twice, so you usually get two zeros. Okay, not always, but many times you do. And so what this plus or minus symbol here means is that x is going to be equal to one of two things. It's going to be equal to either negative 3 plus 9, all divided by 4, or x is going to be equal to negative 3 minus 9, all divided by 4. And so you need to find both answers, both negative 3 plus 9 over 4 and negative 3 minus 9 all over 4. Well, when I do negative 3 plus 9 over 4, I get 6 over 4, which just becomes 3 halves or 1.5. So one of my zeros is 1.5. The other one, when I do negative 3 minus 9, I get negative 12 over 4, which just becomes negative 3. So your other zero is negative 3. So what that means is, if I go back to the very beginning, had I graphed this at the very beginning on my calculator, I would have gotten two zeros, one at 1.50 and the other one at negative 3.0. Those would have been my two x-intercepts on the graph. Okay, so that's how the quadratic formula works. It seems like it's a really, really long process. It does get a lot easier once you practice, as all things in math do. Let's go down to number 2 and try this again. Okay, for number 2, let's list our A, B, and C values. For this one, your A value is just 1. You have a 1x squared there. Same thing for your B value. Your B value is also 1. Your C value is positive 12. So again, the first step, I want you to write down the entire formula. X equals negative B plus or minus the square root of B squared minus 4ac all over 2a, and then we'll plug in our a, b, and c values to that formula. Okay, so my b value is 1, so I'm going to start with negative 1 plus or minus 1 squared. That's where my b values go. Minus 4 times a, a is 1, so it goes here and down here, okay, below. And then your c value is 12, which goes right there. So we have negative 1 plus or minus 1 squared, the square root of 1 squared minus 4 times 1 times 12 all over 2 times 1. Let's simplify that a little bit. So you've got a negative 1 plus or minus the square root of, underneath your square root sign, 1 squared is just 1. You have a negative 4 times 1 times 12 here. Negative 1 times 4 times 12 is going to give you a negative 48. So you get 1 minus 48 under your square root sign. All over, 2 times 1 is just 2. So this becomes negative 1 plus or minus the square root of, 1 minus 48 is negative 47. So you get a negative 47 under there, all divided by 2. At this point, you're actually going to stop doing the quadratic formula, because if you notice, under your square root sign, you have a negative number. And the definition of a square root is a number times itself, so that you get the number under the square root. Well, you can't take any number times itself to get a negative number, which is why you can't take the square root of a negative. Anytime you try to take the square root of a negative, you're going to get an error on your calculator. So anytime this happens in the quadratic formula, we call this a no solution. So this would be a graph, if you tried it on your graphing calculator, that would actually not cross the x-axis. It would be entirely above the x-axis. It would look a little bit like this. Here's your x-axis. Okay, and here's what the graph would look like. It just wouldn't touch at all, so there are no zeros, therefore no solution to this problem. Okay, number 3, we have 2x squared plus x equals 7. The first thing I need to do for this problem is I need to put this equation into standard form, because it's not in standard form already. That just means I need to set it equal to 0 by subtracting 7 from both sides. So that gives me 2x squared plus x minus 7 equals 0, and now I can identify my a, b, and c values. So my a value for this one would be 2, your b value would be positive 1, and your c value would be negative 7. And let's write out the formula. X equals negative b plus or minus square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. And now we will plug in each of those values to the formula. Okay, so your b value is 1, so we start with a negative 1 plus or minus square root of 1 squared. Your a value is 2, so we have a minus 4 times 2 here, and then this 2 goes down here as well. And then your c value is negative 7, goes right there. Okay, simplifying that formula. I'm going to move down here so I have a little bit more room. We have negative 1 plus or minus the square root of, 1 squared is just 1. Next, think about your sign. You have a negative 4 times 2 times negative 7, so you're going to get a positive here, so a plus. 4 times 2 is 8, times 7 is 56, so we get 1 plus 56 all over 2 times 2, which is 4. Okay, so under my square root sign, 1 plus 56, I get a 57. All divided by 4. Okay, if you go to your calculator now, get out your calculator for me. Your calculator will actually let you go from here. We don't know what the square root of 57 is, because 57, off the top of our heads, because 57 is not a perfect square. Okay, it still exists, but it's going to be a really long decimal. So if you go to your calculator now and go to your scratch pad, here's what you're going to type in. You're going to hit Control Divide, okay, to get a fraction bar on your calculator. Control Divide. And so on your calculator, you're going to type in this. You're going to type in negative 1 plus on the top, then hit your square root symbol, hit control and then x squared, that'll give you your square root symbol, square root of 57, and then on the bottom you're going to do a 4, so make sure it looks like that, negative 1 plus the square root of 57 all over 4, and then if you hit enter from there, it should give you the decimal of approximately 1.64. That'll probably give you something like 1.637 4586, okay, which is approximately equal to 1.64. We're going to round to two decimal places. So that right there would be one of your zeros, one of your answers, 1.64. Okay, your other answer would be from doing negative 1 minus the square root of 57 all over 4. So if we do negative 1 minus the square root of 57 all divided by 4, you're going to get approximately, let's see, approximately negative 2.14. So about negative 2.14 is what you get for that one right there. So your two zeros you would get would be 1.64 and negative 2.14. Okay, for the last problem, number 4, we're going to first of all set this in standard form, so subtract 9 from both sides. So do that here and here. That gives you x squared plus 16x plus 55 equals 0. What I want you to do now from here is I want you to pause the video and I want you to try this last one on your own. Try identifying the A, B, and C values and plugging each of those into your quadratic formula and see if you get to the answer I get to. Once you've done that, click play to go ahead and check it, please. All right, let's check your answers to this one. So you can see my work here, hopefully. Right up here, I identified A is 1, B is 16, C equals 55. And so here's where I plugged in my A, B, and my C values. And then moving down, I simplified each step. First of all, under the square root, 256 minus 220 became 36. Square root of 36 was 6. So I knew that x had to be either negative 16 plus 6, which is negative 10, over 2, which is negative 5. That's one of my zeros. Or negative 16 minus 6, which is negative 22, divided by 2, which is negative 11. So you get two zeros of negative 5 and negative 11. As always, any questions you have over this video, be sure to jot those down and shoot those to me in email. And we'll practice this the next time I see you in class. Until then, have a nice day. You're all wonderful people. Take care.